so as the net was essentially tightening around all of the Jewish citizens here in Amsterdam, the Franks themselves actually tried to emigrate legally. They applied for exit visas and attempted to immigrate to all three of Canada, US, and United Kingdom, and they were rejected at all three. So it's really obviously a sad case. Many of us forget just how even in what we like to consider the sort of liberal, proud allied countries, just the latent anti-Semitism, and also even just the sort of isolationist policies, even trying to not have competition with jobs, things like that, in that time period. So the Franks couldn't get out legally, and by 1942 they decided, the father, Otto Frank, had been working on converting what was the back annex of his office. So from the street, you can't actually see, it just looks like a normal canal house, but happens to be a back section that he had been converting, ready for them to try to go into hiding. And sure enough, they had to make a fleeting sort of dash through the night one evening to get into their hiding, and they didn't leave for 2 years. Didn't see the light of day, a breath of fresh air, for 2 years. And it wasn't just the Frank family, so the mother, the father, and their two daughters, Anne being the younger, the two daughters, she was 13 when they went into hiding. Within a certain amount of months, there was actually another family who was staying in there with them, so all told, it was eight of them living in this small, several-room annex in the back of this house. Now, it's not known, actually, just how they were discovered, finally. In 1944. There's two theories. The one that's long been predominant is that they were tipped off, that someone had finally decided to rat them out, essentially, and collect the reward money that was being offered for any information on hiding Jews in the city. But actually, just in the last several months, a new theory has come to light through research that they believe part of the main residents of the Canal House were involved in fraudulent food stamps. They're forging food stamps, which were required to hand to the Nazis to get your rationed allocations in those days of occupation. And so it was actually more of a raid trying to deal with these people forging the food stamps that just happened to uncover the sliding bookshelf that then led to that back annex. And so Anne herself and her sister actually both escaped the gas chambers at Auschwitz, which was the unfortunate fate of so many Jews who were sent to concentration camps. They survived Auschwitz only to be forced on a march and train trip in the last months of the war, spring of 1945, forced to Bergen-Belsen, the last, one of the last concentration camps to be liberated by the Allies. And it's there that Anne perished, we believe, from just sort of complications of an illness. She had typhoid through those spring months of 1945 and dying at such a young age there. It was her father, Otto, the father of the family, who was the only one to survive, returned to the house here in Amsterdam, and that was where we found the diary that she'd been keeping. The diary itself was a present from her father on her 13th birthday. She was an aspiring journalist, and she wanted to be an author when she grew up. She dreamed of being a bestseller. How little could she have imagined that she indeed would become one of the greatest sellers of the 20th century.